Orangeburg, the county itself, has immensely talented people. It's definitely, and people use the phrase a diamond in the rough, but we are, I would say, under spotlighted and underrepresented because it's a number of people from academia, from athletics, from just their overall social impact. We have change makers and people who exude excellence that come from Orangeburg, right? My high school experience was phenomenal, very active, was in Key Club, was student body vice president my junior year. And I forgot to turn in my application my senior year. So I was going to run for president, but I forgot to turn it in. But I had a really, really good experience. But back in 2009, me and my colleague Alex Schuler, we would come home for Christmas and we wanted to put something together back for everyone who was back home for the holidays or still living in Orangeburg. Over Christmas. And so we started something called Annual Christmas Bash. And it was a cool event that we would try to do different things. One year it was a canned food drive. The other year we said, man, let's raise money for a HBCU bound scholarship. That's really what we should do. We're going to take this money, we're going to get a DJ, have all our classmates come out, drink specials and things of that nature, but let's like give back to the community, right? And so we ended up doing like a $500 scholarship, and the requirements of it was you had to be a graduating senior from Orangeburg Wilkerson High School, right? Going to an HBCU. I think the next year, I think we did another canned food drive, and then the year after that, we did another scholarship. And we said, okay, we want to have this based to Orangeburg County. Just anyone who's in Orangeburg County, if you want to say Edisto or Bowman or North, whoever it would be, if you were close to that consolidated school district, you had an opportunity to go to get a book scholarship. We want people to actually do their research to understand the history and importance of HBCUs, because it was at a point in time that, my parents, when they were going to school, they couldn't have gone to South Carolina or Clemson because of the color of their skin, not because they didn't have the academic criteria to get in. And that was a thing that even growing up, it was a standpoint where my parents didn't have a choice. The only higher education place they could go was Allen, Morris, Benedict, Denmark Tech, South Carolina State, those schools that are in the area. I'd say from an educational standpoint, I know that Orangeburg schools always got a bad rep, but what I would also say is for the people who really apply themselves, when people and all my friends, we've all talked about this. We've all gone off to college and compared ourselves to other students or other people who went to private schools or these other big school districts. I feel like people from Orangeburg always held their own.